Hi, I'm Sarah, and this is my friend Noor. We are from Erbil Nilüfer Girls College, and our math project is about balanced parentheses problem, which is a problem that can be modeled in an explicit formula. For n pairs of parentheses can be grouped into a balanced parenthesis, where the number of open parentheses equals to the number of closed parentheses, and each open parenthesis matches with a closed parenthesis. For example, here we have one pair of parentheses, and it's only one way to group it. If you have two parentheses, there are two ways to group it. And three, there are five ways to group it. But it will be hard by drawing and knowing in how many ways we can group them. So here we got some formulas. First is recursive formula, which is choosing a starting term and repeatedly applying the same process to each term that arrives at the following. So we all know that any group of parentheses always begins with an open parenthesis that has a match with closed parenthesis. And between this pair, there are many groups of other balanced parentheses. But when we have a big valued number instead of that n, we use some other formulas. That, my friend?
If the n is a big valued number, we use the explicit formula, which can be formed from by using generating function. And generating function is then the function polynomial that forms from the power of x and the integer coefficient. And by using these formulas, we can get this the main formula that we have got at the end of our project. And it's to find how many ways can write the parentheses. And we can use this formula in many more applications.
We use this formula not only for this problem, but for many more applications. That here are some examples. And these applications can be understood by undergraduates and non-mathematicians also. For example, here we have an application to triangulating polygons. That here n has to be bigger or equal to 3. If it's triangle, it's only one way to triangulate it. If it's square, there are two ways to triangulate it. If it's a pentagon, there are five ways to triangulate it. And so on. By using our formula, we can get it. And another.
We also use it for stacking coins on each other. And we use this formula for knowing how many ways do we have to stack coin on each other, which n is equal to the number of coins that are in the bottom coins. And we can't add any coins to the sides of the bottom coins. And every additional coin must be over two coins. And thus.
And another applications we have here is permutations. To find the permutation of some numbers, we can use our formula. But the kind of permutation that avoids three terms to be consecutive. For example, if n is 1, there's only one way to write it. If n is 2, there are two ways. If n is 3, there are five ways. Actually, when n is 3, there are six ways of arrangement. But here we use 1, 2, 3 avoiding permutation. It means like three terms cannot be consecutive, and for finding this we use our formula. And we just have another example.
And this example is about how can the students here can shake hands in that sit on the on a round table without their hands being crossed, like here. If we have one pair of person sitting on a round coin, there's only one way of shaking their hands without their hands being crossed. And if you have two pairs of people sitting on a round table, there are only two ways to shake their hands. It's like this one and here. And if you have three pairs of person sitting on a round table, there are five ways of shaking their hands without their hands being crossed. And so on. The others are the same like this. And it's all about, and we have about 600 examples of using our formula, and it's all about our project.